Hello everyone. Today I'm going to be showing you a little bit about colors in general. I'm going to be sharing what I know about colors and mixing a little bit just with the basics. So if you see here, I've actually written down what the classifications that in my opinion would help you get a lot of colors just using the primary shades. Now what I have shown you here are the three primary shades, which is red, yellow and blue. I've just mixed it and kept it. I've written it as well. So let's do one thing. We'll just take a little brush and so this is obviously red. This one is yellow, and this one is blue. So we have three shades that are clear. There is obviously no confusion in this. Now, primary colors, obviously, when we combine primary colors, when we combine two primary colors is when we end up getting the secondary shade. Now remember that these are just the basic parts of it. You can always try and experiment as much as you want, but this should at least help you get you a lot of colors using just the three. And the proportion, there is always a plus or a minus to it. In my case, what I'm going to be showing you is equal proportions. And so that's again just an approximation. So you will need to know how much you're taking. Make sure that all the three paints are equally diluted, just to avoid any amount of confusion. So in this case, what I've done is I've taken equal quantities of paint, mixed in about 2 drops of water in each of them, mixed it well and kept it. That's all is what I have done. Beyond that, now obviously I have mentioned a classification over here, secondary. When I say secondary, I get a shade of orange when I combine red and yellow. I have red and yellow over here. So what I'll do is I'll take about 3 brushfuls of diluted yellow paint, 3 brushfuls of red paint, and this helps me get more of a deep orange color. Let's apply that on this one. This gives me a deep orange color. Yeah. When I combine yellow and blue, it gives me a green color. When I combine a red and a blue, it gives me a deep violet color. I'll just add a hint of red more to it. It gives me a dark violet color. I'm not sure if you can actually see the exact color orientation through this. I've tried to keep the lighting as neutral as possible. But you know, it should end up giving you quite good results when you mix it on your own. Not sure if you can see it, but when you try and lighten it, you can see that it's a yellow, because on a white backdrop you're able to kind of clearly make that color out. So once that is done, we move on to the tertiary colors. The tertiary is basically a combination of primary and the secondary colors. So in this case, I have clearly mentioned if you combine, say, a red and a violet, let's see the result of that. I have already violet here. So if you see, I have my primary and I have my secondary colors already done here. Now, let's work on the first combination. The first is obviously a little bit of red. I'm washing my brush in between each of them, and violet. It gives me this kind of a color, more of a purplish, deep mauve kind of a color. I don't know if you can see it, but you know. Next, we combine the blue and the violet. So we have blue, and you have violet. It gives you another shade of the same blue, but just a different shade. We mix blue and green. You get a bluish green color, which kind of makes what do you say, when you're trying to draw like a sea life kind of a painting, or if you're trying to get like an aqua green kind of a color, this would ideally be the combination, you know, when you mix blue and green. Now we move on to yellow. Yellow when mixed with green gives you a shade of a leafy kind of a green. We combine yellow and orange. You get a lighter shade of orange, more used for sunset, or you know, a combination of painting sunsets. So you see the difference between this orange and this orange. It's obviously lighter, and these help in gradient colors. Like when you're drawing a sunset, you want something which is, you want shades ranging from red to orange to yellow. So that's where, you know, these many colors kind of come in use. The last one would be red. Orange. This color also works beautifully when you're trying to, you know, get a deep orangish red kind of a shade. This is more of a deeper orange, a reddish orange color, which is just perfect when it comes to, you know, when you're trying to work on especially things which are dealing with, you know, a sunset, or colors that you're trying to imitate are that of a sunset. It just works perfectly well. So this is just a basic part of it. There is a lot more you can do. You can try and combine various other colors, probably try and combine four or more. But whatever that you do, try to remember the proportion. Like for example, what I was doing is, I had, every time I was mixing a color, if I'm taking three brushfuls of equally, and okay, before that, I had mentioned that all of the colors are equally diluted. The three of them, all equally diluted, okay? And what I was always doing is, if I took about three brushfuls of yellow paint, I knew, okay, I wanted three brushfuls of yellow paint. And if I say want only, you know, two brushfuls of red, then remember that when you are doing, you know, the rest of your painting. If you want, you can also make these different colors and store it into these little bottles which have an airtight cap, so you don't have to really keep mixing it. Because what happens is, when you are manually mixing these colors by hand, there is a good chance you might not get the exact color each time. There would be a small difference, and that may not look good, especially when you're trying to make this on a piece of jewelry, for example. Like for example, first time I might get a deeper red, second time I might get a shade which is you know, which is probably a lighter, because I must have mixed in more yellow in comparison to the red. So you may just want to watch out for that. But just remember that we got this complete shade card only using these three shades, only using these three colors, the primary colors, the blue, the yellow and the red. That's it. So, I mean, you know, it's a lot of fun if you try and experiment with it. You know, just take a piece of white paper, preferably a thick sheet, that you're able to kind of figure out what colors you like and what you don't, and you know, you can be really creative about it. This is just the basic part of it. A friend of mine had asked me to share a video on this, so I'm doing this. I really hope it helps. It at least gives you a few details on how I kind of play with colors. So that's it, everyone. Thank you so much for watching the video. I really hope you like it, you enjoy it. If you do, then like the video and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Thank you so much for watching, everyone.